We get it from my mama.
What's up, YouTube, y'all? It's me, Tia, you know, the one and only. So, I know you guys are used to Tyke cooking in the kitchen or whatever, and I'm just like being the sidekick.
Yeah.
Don't start. But today, I'm actually cooking, and I will be posting the recipe for this hamburger. What is it called?
Hamburger casserole.
For this hamburger casserole. So let me start with telling you what the ingredients are. So it's actually a bacon cheeseburger casserole. Not a hamburger type messed me up. But anyway, so you're going to need cheese. I love cheese. So I have, well, I got three because they were $3 for $5. But you'll need two things of cheese right here.
It makes her constipated.
You can suck my dick. And we have shredded lettuce. And Ty gonna send me the grocery list and then go put in parentheses produce section. Like I didn't know where the shredded lettuce was. Like that's messed up. And then we have bacon. And then we have a tomato. And then we have minced garlic cloves. This stuff right here. And we have eggs. We gotta put eggs in there. And we have salt, we have salsa, we got pepper, and we got onion powder. So all of this is going to create this lovely cheeseburger bacon casserole. Oh yeah, and we got the heavy cream too, we gotta put in there too. I forgot to tell y'all about that, but yeah. All right, so first I'm gonna start off with cutting the bacon. I always struggle with opening this shit. All right, got it. No worries. So you just cut your bacon up into little pieces like this or whatever. Just chop it up or whatever, a little razzle.
All right, so after cutting the bacon, you're gonna go ahead and fry that.
I know y'all probably like sitting back thinking like this is an easy meal, like anybody can do that. Well, I don't care, because I woke up this morning and I said I'm gonna cook for my baby, you know, because she's been cooking all this keto stuff and I'm not really a cook, so you know I'm gonna cook this cheeseburger steak and be happy. But it's gonna be a while before I cook again. I don't know how to multitask, so I gotta do everything one by one because I probably mess up.
Some music in the background
while I cook up something. All right, so while the bacon is cooking still, I'm gonna go ahead and put the eggs in the bowl or whatever. And y'all, I always have trouble with cracking my eggs. I did doing pretty good. That was pretty cool. Okay. How y'all crack y'all eggs? Like, some people, like, can just, like, if I do that, the whole egg gonna smush. Ain't gonna work. Some people can just stick their hand in it. I gotta crack it against something that's sharp. So, right now, I'm cracking it, like, on the edge of the counter. Babe, how you crack your eggs?
Hey! 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 Yeah!
All right, for real. Comment below and tell me how you crack your egg. Oh shit! Y'all, I told y'all. Oh my god! The whole egg goddamn cracked, bro. Let me stop. All right, so I got the eggs cracked in here. I want to make sure I ain't got no shells in here, cause I sure didn't break that. I hope tight get the part with the shell in it. How y'all know when y'all bacon done? Babe! Can you come and look at this bacon?
Go, baby. I'm glad your toes done. Go,
baby.
The bacon is good and crispy now. I did drain it, take all the grease and stuff out, but it's good and crispy. You like it like that?
So I'm about to go ahead and do the ground beef, right? So the recipe, well, the people that posted it only told us to put onion powder and the minced garlic, cloves, things, whatever, in the beef. But you know how black people do. I'm adding some more seasoning to it. Don't overwhelm me.
So Tyke telling me I can't add no recipes in. Just let me cook. But I ain't gonna add no more though. But instead of regular salt, like I showed y'all earlier, I'm gonna use the Himalaya salt. Oh, Himalayan. The Himalayan salt. That's what I'm gonna use. And it's pink. So I'm gonna go ahead and put a spoon of this. I don't know how big this spoon is. I don't know. I'm gonna put the spoon of this right here in there. It smells so good. So I'm putting some of that in there. A little bit more. Then I'm gonna go ahead and do the onion powder. Put some of that in there. I'm gonna go ahead and put some salt and pepper in there. Let me turn the eye down. Go ahead and put some salt in. Some salt and pepper. And this Himalayan salt. Let me put some over there. Hopefully I'll make a boogie. Oh, there we go. That should be good right there. And I don't do the measurements and stuff like that. I mean, I can add that in the description if y'all want me to. If you really like go by measurements and stuff like that. I say that like I'm a pro at cooking, boy. I don't do measurements. Well, I'm doing this here beef right here, this ground beef. Do you guys like clean up as you go when you cook? Or do you just like wait till you do everything and then clean everything up at once? I like to clean up as I go. But thankfully the kitchen was already clean when I started from when Tyke cooked last night. She had made another pizza and it was good. I love pizza. But yeah, I like to clean up as I go. Like, I load the dishwasher as I go. Like, each dish I use after I finish using it, I put it in the dishwasher or whatever. But let me know how y'all like to do when y'all cook. Y'all like listen to music when y'all cook? It just turned me up a little bit. And it calmed my nerves because I get nervous when I'm in the kitchen.
Very nervous.
Because I ain't no cook or whatever, and I just be thinking I'm about to mess something up. But I'm doing it.
You doing
it? I know y'all can't see my face right now, but you know, I had to prop it up like on the stove. But this beef here browning and whatever. Tiger's like sitting right here staring at me. She weird. But yeah. And I think I showed y'all the eggs. I had already cracked them in there. But earlier I was telling you I gotta do everything like one by one. Cause I've been mess something up for real, all the way up. But I'm gonna try to start cooking more and getting into this kitchen or whatever, this kitchen set and whip it up or whatnot.
Another thing I do when I'm cooking, I be eating the stuff like I be just eating as I go. So the bacon. Bacon good, boy.
Why everything going or whatever? I just like to have like little side conversations or whatever. So last year I had to, you know, take anger management. So on a refrigerator, I got my little plan, little stuff that escalates when I, like how my body do when I get mad or whatever. We had went through that. And I circle everything that happens when I get angry. And that's just about everything on the dang on thing. Isn't it crazy? Like almost everything except for these, of course the ones that are not circled.
So thoughts racing, changes to vision, heart beats faster, muscle tense, palms become sweaty, breathing becomes quicker and shallower. Any of y'all having issues? I'm gonna calm down a lot though. Like, I'm trying to get together. I'm trying to remain calm. The class is very helpful. But I have to look at this every day, you know, so I can, like, you know, catch myself before any of this starts happening. But that's, y'all let me know which one y'all have. They also have, like, your hands getting cold, bladder urgency, your adrenal glands, and dizzy or lightheaded. I don't get none of that, whatever, but all that other stuff, all the rest of my God. So the meat is done browning. Next, I am gonna drain it so they won't be all, you know, watery like. So I'm gonna go ahead and drain that. That's the meat. I need some more seasoning on that. That's why I wanted to add my little own thing to it. But this tastes like the garlic and onion powder, whatever. All right, so now what I have to do is mix the bacon in with the ground beef. Mix that up real quick. I don't know if my phone is still on. There we go. So I'm gonna go ahead and add the bacon in with the ground beef. And it's like really crunchy, y'all. I need a spoon. And I'm gonna go ahead and mix that up. Now I'm gonna put this into the pan. Okay, and of course level it out. Level it out. I am gonna use the measurings for this right here. You're gonna need 1 cup of the salsa, the sugar-free salsa. That's the whole thing. You're gonna go ahead and dump that in with the eggs. So now you're gonna need one cup of the heavy whipping cream. And you're gonna pour that over as well. And then you're gonna need just a pinch or two of the Himalayan salt, and you're gonna need some pepper.
You gotta put your elbow in it, babe.
I'm gonna add the pepper. Put the pepper in now.
Come on with the commercials in the back, though.
Disregard that. All right, so now I'm just gonna go ahead and stir this, and I will get back with you guys.
Titan's helping me with the stirring,
and while she's doing that, we're gonna add some of this cheese right here into the bowl.
You extra.
And I love cheese. I can't express that enough. All right, so now that we have everything mixed in this bowl, we're gonna go ahead and pour it into the meat. Get all that cheese. Okay, so, and then I'm gonna go ahead and mix it all together. I'm gonna mix it in the meat. All right, so now everything is pretty much mixed in here. Make sure you heat your oven to 350 before you put this stuff in there. So now what I'm gonna do is top it with the rest of this cheese right here. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and top it off with some more cheese. That's what the rest of the cheese is left. You're gonna top it off. And then you're gonna put it in the oven until it's
What's the word, what's the word, baby? It's
golden.
Yeah. Until it's golden. So you're going to make sure it's golden. And take it out when it's golden.
You did good, babe. I'm so proud of you, girl.
Thanks. All right, so to top off the cheeseburger bacon casserole, you gotta cut up a tomato and get shredded lettuce out just for the top.
So I'm about to cut this up after I wash it off and show you what it looks like on top when it's finished.
All right, guys, so I took it out of the oven and this is what it looks like.
Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. We get it from my mama.